Hey everybody, it's Sarah from Confetti and Kids, and today's theme is one that is super nostalgic for me. It is based off of one of my favorite children's books that I loved when I was little and Brady loves now. Today's theme is If You Give a Mouse a Cookie Day, which is... this is the best. It's the best book ever. And now it's a show on Amazon. I linked some of our favorite episodes down below because if you haven't watched this yet with your kids, it is so sweet, so wholesome, and just, it's so adorable. You need to check it out. So if you give a mouse a cookie day, let's jump right in with crafts. There is one and one craft only to make on If You Give a Mouse a Cookie Day that is essential, and it is a cookie, obviously. We made this cookie that is based off of the craft that Glued to My Crafts blog posted, and I'll link it down below. We did this cute little tissue paper, tan tissue paper craft to make a cookie out of a paper plate, and glued on for our chocolate chips, we used some pom-pom balls in brown, and then you can see here, because we lost a chocolate chip, we used glitter glue to adhere them to the paper plate, and Brady had fun with this one. You know he loves a good glue moment if you've seen any of our videos before. He loves covering his hands in glue and just getting all up in there. So this one was really good for him with the tissue paper, and it dried really nicely. This was covered in glue, but now looks like a beautiful little cookie that I'm so excited to hang on our art wall. And then to keep the food craft theme going, I loved our cookie that we made, but Brady said, hey, what about a donut for dog? And I thought, well, duh, you're right. Dog needs a donut. So we did another little paper plate craft, and it is this donut. These are two pieces of paper plate. So there's one, cut a hole in it, and then I made some frosting that Brady painted pink. And then we used little pieces of pipe cleaner cut up as the sprinkles. And just like the cookie, it was simple. It was perfect for like three and under, two to five-year-olds. Look, I don't know. I think it's great for everyone because I enjoyed it as an adult, but Brady really enjoyed it at 3 and a half, and it was a great little donut tie-in for If You Give a Dog a Donut, which we read later in the day. The last craft we did on If You Give a Mouse a Cookie Day is something I always do, which is look for coloring pages, and I couldn't have been more proud of this find from A to Z coloring, and it's these little M is for mouse coloring pages. Look at how cute this mouse is. So clearly this is mine and this is Brady's. Really adorable. I linked to the printable down below, and this was something that we put on as we watched If You Give a Mouse a Cookie on Amazon. It was a really yucky day, so we watched, you know, a good amount of If You Give a Mouse a Cookie on Amazon, but it was so sweet to be able to tie that in with some coloring and our crafts and have a nice little mouse a cookie moment. To play on If You Give a Mouse a Cookie Day, I found this little matching game. It's rattling around in there, but it comes with all of the little cards, and it's a nice little flip over matching game. There are so many. You can play a pretty big matching game with this set. I broke it down for Brady's age group to be like a little more easy and picked out like one of each character and did it that way. But this is such a sweet game. I got it on Amazon, linked it for you if your child also loves Mouse a Cookie. And this is all of the drawings from the show. So it's a nice little tie in there. And we had fun playing this one on Mouse a Cookie Day, and to this day, it is such a great little game, and I think that matching games are something that I know in my childhood I loved playing all the time. So if you don't have a matching set in your house, this is a great one to start with, and it's a great activity for any day, especially Give a Mouse a Cookie Day. I made a little counting worksheet for Give a Mouse a Cookie Day, and we counted with dot markers. This is the little worksheet I made. It's called If You Give a Mouse a Cookie Count, and in the middle of each cookie is a number, and then you can put that many dots around it in the circles allotted for it. You can do this with coloring too. If you don't want to do dot markers, you can print it out. You can do it with dry erase if you want to do it again and again. But Brady wasn't like super into doing this at first. So that was what made me make it for dot markers, because he gets really jazzed on those. So I thought, all right, let's get a worksheet going. Let's get some learning and counting going. And if we do it with dot markers, I can trick him into having fun and learning at the same time. The last thing we did for play on Give a Mouse a Cookie Day is dress up like Mouse. Brady loves Mouse. He has just so connected with this character. He loves his overalls. He loves mouse ears. He loves mice in general. He always talks about wanting a mouse, which like I'm here for, but we also have a cat, so that seems dangerous. But he loves little mice, and he was so excited to dress up as mouse on If You Give a Mouse a Cookie Day. So I put on little overalls that I grabbed from Zara that I can't wait to have him in all summer long, and little mouse ears that I got on sale from Hannah Anderson for all of like $5. And that was a two simple step costume, and he was mouse all day long. Loved every minute of being mouse. Still loves dressing up as mouse every day. It could not have been a cuter costume, and I'm so happy that he loved this so much and I loved it so much. I'm going to cherish these pictures of him as mouse forever. To eat on Give a Mouse a Cookie Day, we started our day by honoring If You Give a Pig a Pancake by making pancakes. It was the easiest tie-in. I mean, just whipped up a couple pancakes, put a pat of butter on top and some syrup, and you have If You Give a Pig a Pancake. Then the next thing we ate on Give a Mouse a Cookie Day is, I mean, can you guess what we made? We made cookies, and I decided to make them mini, so they were just little cookies, which felt more mouse-like. So we made a bunch of those, and they were fun with mini chocolate chips, and Brady had a fun time rolling them out into little shapes, and we baked them off, and I think they look like really adorable, super small, and I thought that this was a great batch. I included the recipe we used down below. It's a little different than the one I normally use, and it turned out great. So I definitely recommend it, linked it down below, and clearly you cannot not have cookies on Give a Mouse a Cookie Day. To get moving on Give a Mouse a Cookie Day, we did one of our favorite activities, which is hide and seek, and we referenced an episode that I linked down below of the Give a Mouse a Cookie show of when they play hide and seek, because Brady loves that episode, has watched it over and over again since he was very little. So I thought it would be great to do a theme activity of hide and seek, but what I did is I got these little guys. They're so cute, and it came with five of the friends from Mouse a Cookies. Here's Mouse, he's so sweet, and Pig. And these were tiny little stuffed animals that then we hid around the whole house, and Brady had his little checklist, which I also made. This one here, and I did dot markers again, motivation with dot markers. And he went around the house and found cat, dog, moose, pig, and mouse, and found them. And then I printed this out again, and he did it again and again. Loves a good round of hide and seek. And these guys, the little stuffed animals, were cute and small and able to like nestle into different spots. So it was a fun way to get moving around the whole house on Give a Mouse a Cookie Day. To finish up the day on Mouse a Cookie Day, you know, after we do all of our activities, we read, and can you guess what we read? Mouse a Cookie books. I found this big box set, Fun with Mouse and Friends, at Costco, and I linked it down below. Hopefully they're still available. I know Costco is touch and go with books, but this set has a great starter selection of all of the mouse books. There are so many mouse books, so you can really go crazy and get a bunch of different kinds, but this is your starter set, and then you can always, this did not come with Give a Dog a Donut, but we got that one separately. And we read these all throughout the day on Mouse a Cookie Day, and then we read them all again at bedtime, and it was a great way to close out Give a Mouse a Cookie Day. That's it, guys. Mouse a Cookie Day, that's a wrap. Thank you for watching, and as always, make sure you download the PDFs down below that will help guide all of your activities for Mouse a Cookie Day. Like this video if you liked it, subscribe to see more videos coming soon, and make sure you leave a comment down below of everything that you want to see coming, you know, any themes you want us to try, I'm open. Let me know what you want to see, and as you do theme days, feel free to tag us on social on Confetti and Kids on Instagram. I love seeing everyone do the days. It makes me so happy. So thank you for following along, and we will catch you next time.